purpose of UI, how to build it and where to build it. But at that time, Hungary was competing for the neutron facility. And therefore, Hungary was not intended to host UI. We were participating there because it was a very important endeavor for European laser physics. But we thought, okay, fine, Hungary wants to host the neutron, the neutron facility. Then there were actually in the Hungarian press you could read basically the neutron facility is practically in our pocket. But that I accidentally met a colleague of mine who I knew that he was very knowledgeable in Brussels, and I asked him what the chances for the neutron facility, how he sees the chances. And he told me that, in my opinion, 95% Lund, 5% Barcelona, and the rest of the rest is Hungary. I thought that there was not quite what I read here in Hungary. And then there was a meeting in the ministry for some different purposes, but then I went to the Deputy Secretary of State, who was responsible for the projects, and I told them that, okay, but I suggest to you that Hungary has a plan B. I understand that plan A is to use some facility, but we should have something. So why don't we go for a plan B as well? And I told him that ENI could be a nice plan B. Then eventually he agreed. And then we actually started to apply for hosting the ENI. But we were late because the Czechs, the Romanians, the French, and the at that time the UK, they have already been working on their application for hosting the ENI. So we barely met the deadline to send in the hunting application. It was 2008. Then 2009, early 2009, there was this meeting in Strait that I mentioned where I met Solomon Saltier, where actually it was the formal site selection procedure. But it turned out that there were five applications, the three from the new member states, Hungary, Czech Republic, Romania, but France and the UK. It turned out that the three new member state applications had a strong governmental commitment. Of course, the scientific community was weaker than in France or UK. On the other hand, there was really no government commitment behind the two other applications. So basically it turned out that if there will be a chance to be, that could be only in some of the new member states. But then there was another aspect, that all these new member states were considering cohesion funds. Cohesion funds cannot be brought out from the country, so basically it turned out that there will be no way to build a far place the whole UI. And so then a total process of redesign started. How could we make it on three pillars such that it is still efficient? The pillars have their identity, but they collaborate. So the UI is still a single pan-European system. But geographically, it is on three pillars. And that was actually quite a tricky process that took almost another year. But then in the October 2009, the ELI steering committee decided that the three countries should build the three pillars. But this during the summer, of course, it was really very heated discussion